Despite the astonishing progress we've seen in car safety technology, driving is still, inarguably, a dangerous feat. So what would happen if, instead of evolving our cars to be safer, we evolved ourselves? In 2015, US auto manufacturers sold 17.5 million cars and light trucks, smashing a 15-year-old record. And there's no question that cars are becoming increasingly sophisticated. But humans aren't evolving as fast as the cars we create, and our bodies aren't physically capable of withstanding the forces we encounter in car accidents. According to the NHTSA, over the course of 2014, there were 32,674 accident-related fatalities in the US alone. But what if we could evolve past our current state? What would we look like if our species adapted specifically to the rigors of automobiles? Meet Graham. Graham is the result of a collaboration between artist Patricia Piccinini, trauma surgeon Christian Kinfield, and collision expert David Logan. Their team asked what humans would look like if we were built to survive on the roads. The differences between Graham and the average person are striking, to say the least. First, his skull is much, much larger than average. Our brains flow in cerebrospinal fluid surrounded by a skull designed to fracture and spread the force of an impact. Graham's brain is the same as ours, but it's encased in a better helmet. It's surrounded by more fluid, and his skull has, essentially, crumple zones, allowing him to survive a much stronger impact than you or I could. Second, Graham's face is super flat and covered with fatty tissue to protect his nose, his sinuses, and his ears from steering wheels, dashboards, and breaking glass. Third, the neck. Or rather, the lack thereof. Since the neck is one of the most vulnerable points of the body in a crash and incapable of preventing the head from jolting forward, Graham has none. He has no neck. His ribs just go all the way up to the skull. Let's follow those neck ribs down to his rib cage. It's filled with organic airbags, which excrete a fluid upon impact, providing much more protection than our conventional musculoskeletal structure. These provide an opportunity for a more gradual stop during the forward momentum of an accident. Graham's skin is also thicker and tougher to reduce the likelihood of abrasions. Finally, and honestly, this is probably the coolest part, Graham has an extra joint in his feet, allowing him to execute a super jump when he needs to GTFO out of Dodge. You know, like a grasshopper or like the Hulk in the Marvel movies. Before I get too carried away with this, we should point out that Graham is not a living being, and there are, at this point, no plans to make him one. Instead, Patricia and her team intend Graham to be a catalyst for conversation. He's an educational tool meant to emphasize the importance of safety systems and to remind us how vulnerable we all actually are. And there's another question here. Would you trade bodies with Graham? What sort of evolutionary perks would you take given the chance? I'd love to breathe underwater, for example, but I'll admit, the spring-loaded jump thing is pretty cool. Anyhow, thanks for watching. Go ahead and subscribe while you still have fingers that can click things, and visit us for more of the weirdest, newest tech and science over at now.howstuffworks.com.